sailor, airman, and marine understood what you understand, knew what you know, felt what you feel about freedom. Imagine if they had that conviction in their hearts and in their minds and in their souls to be a warrior for liberty. Would you fear them anymore?
No!
You would not. And that's why I invite you, I invite all Ron Paul supporters to join us in our mission and help us reach out to the troops and teach them the message of freedom. If you do that, that's the last thing the power elites want to do. When I get up in the morning, I think to myself, what does Barack Obama not want me to do? What does Mitt Romney not want me to do? What does Mark Potok not want me to do? And then I go do it. Now, I had the honor of serving on the staff of the single most consistent defender of the Constitution since Thomas Jefferson. I worked for Congressman Ron Paul. Yeah. And what, as was said earlier by so many speakers, what he did is he ignited brush fires. He lit brush fires in the minds of men. He ignited a mental revolution. And that revolution has caught fire and is spreading fast. And I know that given enough time, we will win. And they know it too. And this is the problem, is what I fear is that the powers that be understand that their time is limited, that eventually we will win if given enough time. And so my concern and fear is they will try to stop the free exchange of ideas and the internet revolution and free communication among the people, which has sparked and spread this fire of liberty. My concern is they will try to use the only tool they have, which is force, to try to crush the revolution before we can be successful in a peaceful manner. That's my great fear. That's why I urge you to take the same spirit you've had about going, waking up your fellow Americans and focus on the people with the guns. Focus on the military especially, focus on the police, and also focus on the veterans. The veterans in this country, all of whom swore that same oath, are a key population. Two key populations will determine the fate of liberty in this country if and when the powers that be try to drop the hammer on us. The military and the veterans. What the military does can shape history. What the veterans do can shape history. If the military stands down like in East Germany or Tunisia, we can have a peaceful restoration, a peaceful return to the Constitution and the principles of the Declaration of Independence. But even if not all of them do, even if some of them do follow orders, even if we don't reach enough of them in time, you will have a division within the military, and you will see veterans standing up. And so the question I asked at the beginning of this speech was, which do you choose, 1774 or 1934 Germany? Well, guess what? The veterans of this country have already chosen. We will not let this country go the way of Nazi Germany. We choose 1774. And the message to the current serving military and police is that you will not have the choice of just going along with tyranny over the American people. We will force you to fight us. We will force you to kill us. If you violate your oath, you will have to fight us. And you won't be tyrannizing the American people, because you and me and you and us veterans will be too busy killing each other. I don't want to see that happen. But that's the resolution we have to have. You need to be ready and willing to fight and die for freedom to preserve it. You can't just be intellectual warriors. You need to be ready in case you have to. But how do we stop that from happening? How many here have seen the Gray State trailer? That is what's coming down the road. Now, why do I sound so urgent? You know what the NDAA is, don't you?
Yeah.
It is a declaration of war on the American people. That's exactly what it is. Authorizing military force, that's killing you, military detention and military trial or rendition to some foreign country. That is exactly the kind of abuse of power that led to the first American Revolution. And yet, now all three branches and both major political parties assert that power over you. That is why the hour is late. We are very close to the Solzhenitsyn moment where you must resist. We are very close to the Patrick Henry moment. I urge you, if we have one last chance, a narrowing window of opportunity for a peaceful restoration, we must spread the message of liberty among the troops. God bless America.
Yeah. Yeah.